Another one of the tuning parameters is this parameter called MarkArchiveGaps. When turned on, what we're doing is we're actually marking the gaps in the archive. As you can see right here, at this point we don't have any more data because an archive that spans this time range here appears to be offline. So we show this arc offline digital state in that case. So some people don't like to see that and they'd like to turn that feature off, so that's why we have the tuning parameters. And let's take a look at how we would make that change. I'm going to switch over to the PI System Management Tools. And let's, within here, go into, let's take a look at this. Yeah, let's take a look at before and after. We'll take a look at the archives and take one of them offline. Let's see, this would give us a gap from 1 to 2 p.m. today, so I'm going to take this offline. I'll go ahead and unregister this archive. Okay. Incidentally, one of the more interesting things you can do with this is to show markers where gaps occur. So in this case, by turning that on within here, there we go, I can show where there is a gap. So in this case, we're showing that's a gap. That's basically a marker showing us that there's a gap in the data. But the real proof would be to go out to a copy of PI ProcessBook, and let me refresh my screen. So you can see now that I've refreshed my screen, there is definitely a gap. We see the gap appear, and if I were to draw a trend cursor there, let me drop a trend cursor, you see this arc offline. Well, as I said, you can change that behavior. I'll go into the System Management Tools. Let's go into the Tuning Parameters. And I'll go into the tab called Archive, and let's say Mark Archive Gaps. As you can see, the current value right now, the default value, I should say, is 1. And I'm going to turn that off by setting the value equal to 0. Now, to be honest, I've forgotten whether this is going to update immediately or not. Let's see what happens when I refresh my screen here. No, I believe this is not going to take effect until the next time we stop and restart one of the subsystems. And since I believe that this is not going to take effect, the change here is not going to take effect until the archive process is stopped, let me go into the general services, PI services, and stop and restart the archive subsystem. So I'll go ahead and stop and restart. And here I am. I've fast-forwarded a bit, and I've stopped and restarted the archive subsystem. And now if you take a look, those gaps are no longer being shown. And that's not necessarily a good thing. It really depends on your goal. Of course, the problem now is the data is in fact missing, but there's no indication that the data is missing. So that's something that you can set using that. It's the mark archive gaps in the tuning parameters. Now, there are a whole variety of other tuning parameters that we may ask you to set if you're involved in some troubleshooting with tech support. So that's, as I said, it's like getting under the hood and tinkering with the operation of the system. And that's in the tuning parameters in SMT.